What's up guys? Welcome back to the channel. iPhone battery is always a trouble for most users, for no reasons, it just always drains fast. And recently, many iPhone users reported that their iPhone battery drained or died so fast. And the common ground is that they all update their iPhone to iOS 15.3.1, that is, the latest version of iOS system. It seems that the problem not only happened on those battery life is shorter than 80% but also on the healthy one. It's obvious that it has something to do with the software, and it said that the issue would be solved in the upcoming iOS 15.4. I have already made a video on how to fix iPhone battery drain using common ways. If you have interest, you can check it out, also link in description below. But today I will guide you through a deeper aspect to better understand why your iPhone battery drained so fast even you didn't do anything. So now let's jump right in. The first part is about iCloud photos. If you have an Apple ID logging on your phone, you probably have turned on the iCloud Photos option, or it just turned on itself by default. To be noticed that once a new photo is adding to your album, it would start uploading to iCloud, which at the same time, using the battery as well, especially if you allow it to upload through cellular data. The second part is about the apps. The most straightforward way is to check out battery usage by app and settings. Here you can find out which app actually take up the most battery usage. And along with the new iOS system, there may be apps not compatible yet. You can start by removing any VPN or security apps. Apart from being totally unnecessary, they are also a strong contender for runaway power usage redirecting your web traffic. Also, any streaming apps or apps that can run with phone closed are occupying your battery life. So always remember close them entirely, despite the accepted wisdom not to. Then comes the location service, which we have mentioned in the last video. But I still want to underline this, which is in the privacy settings and location services. Make sure most of the apps say never, unless it's a location required app. Then is the cellular. As known as mobile data, make sure you have turned off as many functions as possible, as cellular uses more power than Wi-Fi. The next part is about Hey Siri. Believe it or not, if you turned on always listen for Hey Siri, it would just continually waits and listens. So, turn it off. And use buttons. 6. Raise to wake. I bet you don't even realize this is optional. But yes, you can also turn it off and display settings, as it also continually waits for movement. And the 7th part is about live photos. Some users like to turn on live photos as it can record more than just one moment. But this also means your iPhone will continually run video and wait for you to press the shutter while camera is on. So I suggest you turn it off. And the final part, screen time. You might turn on screen time since you activate your iPhone, but it also monitors your usage and needs power for that, which is somehow quite useless. So I suggest you turn it off as well. So after all these reasons and solutions, if you want to restore your iPhone to factory settings, you can go to Settings and General. Scroll down to find Reset. And choose Erase All Content and Settings. Backup before you do this step. If you prefer an easier solution to refresh your system, you can try TenorShare Reboot to standard repair your system, which is safe and fast, and you won't lose any data. I have also left the download link in description below. Go and try it if you have interest. Okay, so that's all for today's video. If it helps, don't forget to give us a thumbs up. I would be very grateful if you subscribe. And stay tuned for our next video.